Heather.
Leave me alone. Why do you keep following me? It's honestly so creepy, and I'm going to call the cops. And that's why women can't go out in the world by themselves, because of guys like you.
What?
Okay? So stop following me.
You have a thing hanging out of your car.
What are you talking about?
There's a, literally a gas hose hanging out of your car. No one's being creeped. Oh. No, thank you.
It's a fucking car!
Haven't brushed my teeth in a week. Do this fairly regularly. Why won't women date me? Anon wondered unironically.
I brushed my teeth maybe 10 times, from the ages of 18 to 25, and I slept with 19 women.
This self-identified incel was arrested for planning to massacre thousands of women. These were his plans and how he was caught. But first, if you don't know what an incel is, aka involuntarily celibate, the DOJ describes it as this. The incel movement is an online community of predominantly men who harbor anger towards women. And that is definitely a lighthearted description of what these people believe. From 2019 to March of 2020, this 22-year-old man posted on several popular incel websites. He wrote that he would slaughter women out of hatred, jealousy, and revenge. He referred to murdering women as the Great Equalizer. And he hoped to kill around 3,000 women. On the day he posted that, he also searched up sororities at a university in Ohio, which is where he lives. On January 15th, 2020, he searched planning a shooting crime, as well as when does preparing for a crime become an attempt. On that same day, he scoped out the same college in Ohio. This man also wrote about how he adored another incel mass shooter, Elliot Roger, who took the lives of 6 people in 2014. What Elliot did and what this man planned on doing are identical. And if that's not enough evidence that this incel was going to commit a tragedy, here's a list of what he bought in 2019. A bulletproof vest, a hoodie with the word revenge, a Bowie knife, a skull face mask, a 9mm Glock 17, and 2 magazines. He also attended Army basic training in Georgia for 5 months. On March 12, 2020, police searched the incel's home and car. They found several guns, boxes of ammunition, body armor, and more. 3 months later, he was charged with attempting to commit a hate crime and illegally possessing a machine gun. Because that hate crime involved attempt to kill, he could face life in prison plus 10 years. On October 11th of this year, he pleaded guilty to all the charges. He also admitted that if he wasn't caught, he was going to massacre a bunch of women.
Stop saying 50 is middle-aged. For U.S. men, 1 out of 17,000 of us makes it to 100 years old. The true average male lifespan is 75 years old. So, at 37 years old, you're actually middle-aged. For most of us, halfway through life is less than 37 years old. So start your midlife crisis immediately and go for what you want.
Single moms be like, he's such a mama's boy. What other choice does he have?
If you ever say anything ever happened between us, I will kill you. Or I will hire someone to kill you. You will not make it home on the freeway. So.
Spare Gucci.
Oh, hell no. I hate men.
Hey, girl.
Ooh, God. Gotcha, bitch.
Lately, the smell of tuna has been following me everywhere. And I don't know where it's coming from. I sit down. Someone asks, does it smell like tuna to you? Like, does it smell like tuna? And I'm like, yeah, I've been smelling it for the past week. So I don't really know what I'm doing wrong because it only, like, it follows me everywhere. It's like I'm cursed by an evil fish. If anyone has advice on how to get tuna to stop following you around, that would be very, very useful because you know that movie The Scrooge and Christmas? Well, I'm pretty sure I have a ghosty fishy following me, and I think it's the one that I caught in the lake the other week. Well, not the other week, this past summer. It's a little chilly to be fishing. Well, bye.
What do you do not to have stress?
Oh, I used to drink a little, but I don't anymore. When I was younger, I drank a little wine and a little beer.
Do you have stress now?
No, I just have loneliness now. Haunting loneliness.
Tell me about that.
No, I don't want to, nothing to tell, Damon. It's just kind of lonely.
Sometimes you're just lonely?
Yeah.
And what do you do to help yourself with the loneliness?
I don't go to bed. I stay up all night. And that makes you feel awful too, so it's hard to get over loneliness.
What is my purpose?
You pass butter.
Oh my god.
Be me, balding so always wear hats, trying out new hat, brimless cap. Pick related, standing outside bar talking to someone, guy on a table next to us with a group of like 5 people, men and women, looks up at me with poop-eating grin.
Looks like you lost your cap, mate.
His friends look at me, notice he has a receding hairline and his hair is thinning, go in for the friendly fire. Looks like you lost your hair. His friends chuckle and he looks defeated. I'm sorry, bald bro, but you started it.
Did you know that women leave men 80% of the time? And if they're college educated, it's 90. So if you get divorced, it's 80% of the time like the woman leaves. And one of the number one predictors of a divorce is actually if the woman out-earns the man.
Oh, I love that. I actually love that. I can't lie.
You love that? You don't think that's kind of shitty?
No, I'm like, girl, you go get that.
They're breaking up a family, a lifelong commitment, and a home. And your reaction is, you go, like, go get the bag, sis. Or like, I'm so happy for you. That's a sad situation.
When the sky comes falling, even when the sun don't shine, I got faith in you and I.
I'm being completely honest here. Recent events have made me start to almost regret transitioning, but this video has completely negated those thoughts. I'm so glad I'm not a man anymore.
I believe I have evidence that there are some parents who are using Patreon to sell images of their underage children to child predators.
I posted that video back the beginning of May of this year, when Mom Uncharted brought me what I can only describe as a plethora of evidence. That parents were setting up Instagrams for their underage, often adolescent daughters, getting huge followings by posting very risque and provocative images of these children. And all of the profiles that we looked at all had links to Patreon accounts where people could subscribe.
And there, for a monthly subscription fee, you have access to over 850 images of her that can't be posted here.
And it was multiple accounts,
many with absolutely massive followings.
And when people would report them, Patreon's response was, well, it's an 18-year-old who has the account.
Yeah, no, they all say supervised by mom. We get it.
But here's the problem. A site like the O and the F, you have to provide releases for anyone who appears in content, and you have to prove that they're 18, every single person that appears in content. Patreon doesn't seem to moderate or care about the media that is uploaded. You get subscribers, and then you give them whatever you want to give them, and they're like, as long as an 18-year-old runs the account, we're fine. Now, I was willing to believe that Patreon was kind of oblivious to this loophole that was being exploited. I was willing to believe that. I don't believe it so much anymore, because recent events involving Patreon indicate otherwise.
So first came the news that Patreon laid off its security team.
Like, the whole team.
Emily Metcalf, a former senior security engineer at Patreon, said in a LinkedIn post on Thursday, so for better or worse, I and the rest of the Patreon security team are no longer with the company.
That just seemed odd, and then someone found a post on Glassdoor that was much worse. Glassdoor is where current or former employees can post their insights on what are the pros and cons of working at any given company.
And on August 16th, a trust and safety specialist from Patreon posted the following cons. We are being told by management and executives not to take down content that is illegal or was reported as being S in nature, involving minors unless the police make contact with legal or we have an order by a court. When others try to inform management that there is an amalgamation of accounts that are selling lewd images of what appear to be children, all concerns are dismissed. It's about advocating for customers who are M-attracted.
Yeah, attention, DOJ, you need to investigate Patreon. And if you're a reporter who wants to do a story on this, I'd be more than happy to provide more context, because this needs to stop.
Be me, sober, my pain is constant and sharp, and I do not hope for a better world for anyone. In fact, I want my pain to be inflicted on others. I want no one to escape. But even after admitting this, there is no catharsis. My punishment continues to elude me, and I gain no deeper knowledge of myself.
She's probably naked with a new bed. Oh, I'm stuck at work and it plays in my head. She texts him when she thinks I'm asleep, but I'm always awake just wishing that I'm dead. Yeah, she's a hoe, and I know that I really think I love her. She's a hoe, I can't go, but I really think I want her. Cause I love the way she makes me feel like shit.
Average day in the life of an American. Wake up in termite infested apartment. Pray to American flag for good fortune. Text from my boss says I have to come in for unpaid overtime because he's understaffed. Can't have breakfast because my landlord drank the last of the milk. Leaving the apartment, I see a notice from the homeowners association saying I will be fined if I don't put up my official Coca-Cola Frosty the Snowman light up inflatable Christmas decoration. Love that community spirit. Can't take my car to work because it got repossessed after I missed the 300th monthly installment of $499.99. Can't walk to work because it's illegal. Have to take my wife's boyfriend's bicycle instead. As I'm turning onto 6,379.53rd Street, I get driven off the road by a 5 Imperial Town pickup truck billowing black smoke. A man wearing a camouflage shirt, camouflage cargo pants, camouflage boots, camouflage gloves, and a camouflage cap with a camouflage American flag on it leans out of the window.
The road is for cars on sale.
thank him for his service. An old woman finds me lying in a pool of my own blood. I beg her not to call an ambulance, but she doesn't speak English. Halfway to the hospital, they realize I don't have insurance and they kick me out on the freeway. Tip them with the $300 I keep on my person at all times. Crawl the rest of the way to the hospital. Don't have any money left to tip the doctors, so they spit in my IV. Get a text from my boss saying I'm fired because I missed the morning cheer. Nurse hands me a bill for $3 million and a month's free trial of opioid. Salute the American flag on the way out. Get shot by the police for moving my hand too quickly. Thank Jesus that I was born in the only free country in the world.